This tutorial shows you how to calculate the minimum required sample size for the Friedman ANOVA, aka Friedman Test, with G-Power. When we start G-Power, we get this overview by default. We now need to select the Friedman Test or Friedman ANOVA first. Even though it is not implemented directly, we can calculate more than a rough estimate using the repeated measures ANOVA, its parametric alternative, and then apply a small correction to the calculated sample size. Select the repeated measures ANOVA via tests, means, repeated measures, within factors, ANOVA approach. Now you have to select the type of power analysis. Since you have to calculate the minimum required sample size in advance, you have to select a priori. The first input parameter needed is the effect size F. However, please be aware that the effect size for the Friedman ANOVA is candles W. Unfortunately, there is no conversion from W to F, forcing you to work with rough estimates. The thresholds for W are 0.1, 0.3 and 0.5 for small, medium and large effect sizes, according to Cohen 92. So, if the reported effect size W for a Friedman test is medium, use the medium threshold of the effect size F. To be more cautious, I recommend always falling back to the thresholds, despite the effect size being more or less above it. The second input parameter is the alpha error probability, which is the probability of committing a type 1 error. In short, this is the probability of wrongly rejecting the null hypothesis. 5% is the typical convention. 1% is a bit more restrictive. A value above 5% should be avoided though. The third input parameter is power. Power equals 1 minus the beta error probability. Beta error is the type 2 error. In short, this means falsely retaining the null hypothesis. 95% power is typical, meaning you have up to 5% type 2 error probability. In some research fields, 0.8 is used here. This means you automatically accept a type 2 error of up to 20%. If you have power lower than 95%, this calls for a reasonable justification. The fourth input parameter is the number of groups. This should be pretty obvious, a Friedman ANOVA or Friedman test has only one group. The fifth input parameter is the number of measurements. This is the number of points in time measurements exist for. For instance, you have a baseline measurement and two follow-up measurements, giving you a total of 3 measurements. The correlation among repeated measurements can be left at 0.5 and only changed if you have specific numbers from previous or preliminary studies. The nonsphericity correction should only be changed if the variances of the differences between the measurements are unequal when it comes to the repeated measures ANOVA. Since that is not a requirement for the Friedman test, leave it at the default value. Finally, hit calculate to see the minimum number of observations needed. Keep in mind that we did the calculation for the parametric repeated measures ANOVA and have to correct for that. Usually, parametric tests need fewer observations, thus we add roughly 15% to the estimate to detect the presumed statistical effect with the predefined type 1 error probability and power. As a rule of thumb, a smaller effect size and a larger power require more observations than the other way around.